Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. In the galaxy of Hanafi Muhaddithin, the name of Imam Yahya ibn Ma'in rahimahullah is as bright as the sun. But before Imam Yahya ibn Ma'in rahimahullah came on the scene, there was another Hanafi Muhaddith with the same name. He was Imam Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Qattan rahimahullah. Imam Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Qattan rahimahullah was born in Basra in Iraq in the year 120 after Hijrah. And he was one of the foremost authorities on the topic of al-jarh wa al-ta'dil, and he was known as the Imam of the people of his time, as well as being known as Amirul Mu'minin fil Hadith, the leader of the believers in Hadith. Such great knowledge he had on Hadith. Not only did Imam Yahya ibn Sa'id have a great knowledge on the issue of the narrators of the Ahadith, but in fact he laid down the foundations for its science that later Imam Yahya ibn Ma'in and others used in their codification of the science that we know today as Ilm al-Rijal or Al-Jarh wa al-Ta'dil. And it was this very Imam Yahya ibn Sa'id rahimahullah that used to take an oath and say, "By Allah, the most knowledgeable person in regards to what has come from Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam is Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah." In other words, no one understood the Quran and the Sunnah better than Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah. Imam Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Qattan rahimahullah, with his immense knowledge on hadith, proudly took to the Hanafi madhab, and he would give fatwa in accordance with the Hanafi madhab as well. If Imam Yahya ibn Ma'in rahimahullah was a great muhaddith, then Imam Yahya ibn Sa'id was even greater in knowledge, because Imam Yahya ibn Ma'in was one of his students, amongst many other shining stars. There is hardly an Imam of hadith from the early generation, but that Imam Yahya ibn Sa'id had studied ahadith under him. And there is hardly an Imam of Hadith from the later generation, but that he had studied under Imam Yahya ibn Sa'id rahimahullah. Think of any big name Muhaddith that lived during that era, and see what he had to say about Imam Yahya ibn Sa'id rahimahullah. Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, Imam Ali ibn al-Madini, Imam Abdurrahman ibn Mahdi rahimahumullah, and others used to often say that they have not seen, and you will not see with your eyes, anyone more knowledgeable in Hadith than Imam Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Qattan rahimahullah. Imam Yahya ibn Sa'id rahimahullah was a firm and strict person. He was engrossed in studying and teaching the ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and therefore never made time for jokes and time wasting. He never laughed boisterously. At most, he would smile. This firm stance of Imam Yahya ibn Sa'id rahimahullah made it such that even when he was young, he was treated with respect and awe by all the people, even those older than him. People sin. It is something that we understand. But the taqwa and the zuhud of Imam Yahya ibn Sa'id rahimahullah was so much that Imam Bundar rahimahullah used to say, "I spent more than 20 years with Imam Yahya ibn Sa'id rahimahullah, and in that entire time, I do not think that he disobeyed Allah even once. And he had absolutely no inclination towards worldly matters." It was the habit of Imam Yahya ibn Sa'id rahimahullah to recite the entire Quran every single day. And despite that, he would then go to the masjid after Asr and narrate a hadith to the people. To understand the greatness of that gathering, one just has to look at the luminaries that used to be present in that gathering. Imam Badruddin al-Aini rahimahullah mentioned that while Imam Yahya ibn Sa'id rahimahullah would sit after Asr, the ulama of hadith like Imam Ali ibn al-Madini, Imam Yahya ibn Ma'in, and Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal rahimahumullah, they would stand in front of Imam Yahya ibn Sa'id rahimahullah asking him about hadith, and he would answer them continuously. And this would last right from Asr until Maghrib Salah. And in this entire time, not even one of the students of Hadith would sit down out of respect for Imam Yahya ibn Sa'id rahimahullah. The great Imam Sufyan al-Thawri rahimahullah, he said he used to be astounded by the memory that Imam Yahya ibn Sa'id rahimahullah had for Hadith. Such was the regard that the great ulama had for Imam Yahya ibn Sa'id rahimahullah, that they would say that whoever abandons Imam Yahya, we will abandon him. This was not said for the sake of being biased, nor was it said by Hanafis for the sake of Imam Yahya being a Hanafi, but this was the general sentiment held by all the ulama of the time, irrespective of what madhab they followed. What they meant was that if a person turned away from studying by Imam Yahya ibn Sa'id rahimahullah, then he obviously has no knowledge of hadith and its people. Therefore, he would disqualify himself from being someone that knowledge could be taken from by that action alone. Imam Yahya ibn Sa'id rahimahullah passed away in Basra in the year 198 after Hijrah, after spending his life of 78 years in obedience to Allah and in service of the deen. When Imam Yahya ibn Sa'id rahimahullah was in his final illness and someone said to him, "May Allah cure you," he replied by saying, "That which is more beloved to Allah is more beloved to me." In other words, I prefer the year after over this world because Allah has given preference to the akhirah over the dunya. And so we pass from this temporary earthly abode into the mercy of Allah Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal. May Allah guide us upon the straight path, the path of those that have come before us in their obedience to Allah, their worship of Allah, their commitment to the Quran and the Sunnah, and those who spend their lives in ways that are pleasing to Allah. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen, wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen.